Mycket välkomna.
Warmly welcome here to this press briefing after our discussion. Warmly welcome to Stockholm, Jens. Always great to have you here. Especially nice to have you here during these times. During my first week as Swedish Prime Minister and my first international visit, I warmly welcome here to this press briefing after our discussion. Warmly welcome to Stockholm, Jens. Always great to have you here. Especially nice to have you here during these times. During my first week as Swedish Prime Minister and my first international visit, I visited Jens at NATO headquarters in Brussels, and this was to demonstrate that because for the government's most important task in terms of foreign policy and security, as I described the declaration of the government, together with Finland to complete the extension to NATO, to strengthen the Swedish defense, and to maintain our obligations as a member and to systematically integrate with NATO's different structures. This is a paradigm shift for the Swedish security policy. This is what we're doing. Just a couple of minutes ago, we finished the meeting with the party leaders for all the parliamentary party who support the Swedish accession to NATO. I wanted everyone to get a chance to get an informal discussion. NATO for many years have been dealing with this security of infrastructure, but after the attacks in the Baltic Sea, we have doubled our military presence in the North Sea and the Baltic Sea. We have also increased the cooperation between NATO countries in to exchange information and to strengthen preparedness to better stop further such attacks in the future. We have created a separate unit to coordinate the measures at the NATO headquarters between the member states and also private industry, which are also important role in terms of this infrastructure to increase the security for undersea infrastructure. Last question, TT. Question to Mr. Stoltenberg. Is there any hope that already on Thursday we can get Turkey to agree that the trilateral memorandum has been fulfilled? Well, I want to be careful in terms of pronouncing about what will come out of this meeting. It will make this meeting even more difficult. What's important is that a meeting will take place, that we get the process going again. And from my point of view, this isn't it. I've said this earlier, but I said it's both in Ankara and Istanbul last year, this autumn, and in Ankara a couple of weeks ago. I made it clear that Sweden and Finland have fulfilled the items, the requirements which follow from the trilateral memorandum. Therefore, the time has come to ratify Sweden and Finland. My question to the Prime Minister, do you believe that the new terror act, will it become a strong blow against PKK's activities in Sweden? Could it lead to further extraditions to Turkey, for example, in any other way? Well, the specific consequences are quite difficult to see right now, but this will be a serious blow against people who take part in terror activities. I'm convinced about that. There are reasons why other countries have legislation of this nature in place. There's a reason why we want to introduce this legislation in Sweden. That's why we change our basic laws in order to create possibilities for such legislation. Some people say that this is quite a profound legislation. I agree, because we have serious issues, serious problems with this issue. The problem in Sweden has been that we didn't take it seriously enough, these types of terror activities or participation or financing, which was directed at other countries rather than Sweden. Now we take it really seriously, and I'm sure that it will be noticeable once legislation has been introduced. Thank you. This is the last question. Thank you. Thank you.